teachers of Reddit. What amusing family secrets did you accidentally learn from your overly talkative students? 8th grader. Excitedly, Mrs. Rosita Kidoki. Guess what I found out? My grandpa was a Nazi. Me. Do you know what a Nazi is? 8th grader. No. Me. Maybe you should go talk to your mom about that. She came in the next day and went, "Yeah, my mom told me I can't tell people about my grandpa anymore." 8th grader. I'm really concerned about this. I had a child once playing on the tire swing. He was a very serious kid and he looked me dead in the eye and said how much he liked the swing at daycare and how when he grew up he wanted to have a swing just like his mummy and daddy did in their bedroom. Looking his parents in the eye that day telling them he had a good day and keeping silent was difficult. See, it's stuff like this that tells me I couldn't be a teacher. Well, there are a lot of reasons really. Your job is silly hard sometimes. I'd be fine with the kids, but the parents. Man, I'd get myself in trouble. Oh, Timmy had a great day. Your son really is a treat. He was having a blast on the swing this morning but he said he wishes it was more like the swing he has at home. I used to do science programming for kids. In the middle of a library summer reading program, I picked a little girl, probably about 4-5 years old, to come up and be my volunteer for a magic trick, which then you explained the science of after it was done. I asked what her name was. She said it into the mic, zero shyness in front of approximately 200 kids and adults. I asked if she had ever heard of the trick we were going to do and she said, "Nope, my favorite dinosaur is a triceratops, and I like your shoes. My dad is back there, hi dad, but my mom couldn't come tonight because she got a shot in her butt and can't sit on the hard chairs this place has." Dad, and all the other adults in the audience were dying. This is a comedian's origin story. She's going to become addicted to making people laugh. Worked at an after-school program run by the YMCA. Once had a 4th grader explain to me in detail how her sister was also her cousin. I knew a girl like this. Her sister cousin came to school with us in 3rd grade. She was introduced as the cousin but the other girl let it slip one day. I knew it was something private so I didn't pry. I went to their house one time and they had a shitload of snakes and I got to hold one. That was peak awesome for an 8-year-old. I didn't give a frick if they were sister cousins. My daughter's kindergarten teacher told me about how one child entertained them at show and tell with a complete report on the new alarm system in their house including the code and where the keypad was located behind the curtains. Kudos going out to all the teachers for glossing over the home stuff they learn. My sister wrote in her daily journal in grade 1 that our parents had a shower together the night before. Teacher wrote, "What a great way to save water." I don't know why I'm laughing so hard at this. We were talking about calling 911, but what a real emergency is. This is tricky with 10-year-olds because you want to use real emergency examples but not freak them out. One kid. So if your mom gives birth in the kitchen, that's an emergency. Sure enough, mom picks him up with his baby brother who was born last week in their kitchen. Well, well, well. Here's a cute and light-hearted one. I had a girl stay for some help after school one day. At the time I was teaching geometry, 10th grade, in a mostly Hispanic school. She told me about growing up in Peru until about the age of 10 or so. I can't remember the exact age she told me. She was telling me that she worked with her uncle sometimes on the weekend. I asked what kind of work. Many of our kids worked construction with their families. He's a clown. I'm his DJ. That really gave me a smile. It may be free, but take this silver. This is awesome. 4th grade. A student on Zoom the other day asked why another student had been gone a few weeks, and we all heard his mom in the back yell, "Boy, that is none of your dang business," before he muted. I almost burst laughing but I held my composure. I did a placement once and students had to talk about what they would do with $1 million. One kid gets up in front of the class and goes, "My mom said if she had $1 million, she would buy lots and lots and lots and lots of weed." God, teachers must have the best dang poker faces. One of my students once said, "Mommy wants to know if you want to come round for tea because daddy is away at work." The mother couldn't look at me 4 weeks on the playground, cause I think she heard her daughter ask me. An 11th grader was talking about how he moved back with his grandparents when his mom dies. He mentioned that his mom also attended the school and so did his dad, but he never met him. He only knew his dad's first name. So he says the name and my get to know other students first day icebreaker. A freshman girl asked a few pointed questions, pulls out her phone and calls their dad. Dad is there within 15 minutes. Turns out the dead mom's family moved mom out of the city to hide the pregnancy and the dad only knew the child's first name. Dad spent years trying unsuccessfully to track his kid down. The dad settled down, becomes a EMT, gets married, has three daughters. The oldest daughter was the freshman. There was a GD family reunion and my icebreaker on the first day of school. While I taught 4th grade, I had a kid tell me that his dad works on car rims at night. Another one told my friend, the bilingual teacher, that she came back from visiting family in Mexico over the weekend by going through the river. Edited to add, another one. I taught the son of a 2nd grade teacher. He came in one weekend talking about drinking lots of kid beer over the weekend at his dad's house. His mom stopped by later and I mentioned the story. She shook her head and said, it's apple juice. I keep telling his dad to stop calling it kid beer. Thanks for the awards. These are my very first ones. Used to teach pre-kindergarten. I had one kid who would tell me every month when her mom was on her period. Mrs. Hey, my mom is bleeding from her butt again at least. I hope that is what was going on or that poor lady had some severe hemorrhoids or mayo. Y-O-Y-I-I-I-LOL. Okay, so not a teacher but in grade 9 there was a girl who got completely plastered in the girls' bathroom. And my 14-year-old self had won too many slushies at lunch so I ran into her there. This girl's makeup was a complete mess and since I was at the peak of social anxiety problems I just tried to slip away. As usual I was too late and this girl clung to my arm and fell apart sobbing to me about how her boyfriend had gotten her mother pregnant. I ended up missing the rest of the day to sit in the corner of the bathroom with this girl I had never met before in my life, and we never talked again. But man, I feel bad for that dysfunction family. I had a Japanese student whose family had formed a music band that practiced in their basement routinely. Unfortunately, I did not get to witness this awesomeness. That's really unfortunate. I had a classmate in elementary school whose dad was in a band. They performed at school events all the time. Several years ago, I did a brief stint teaching junior high. I now teach high school. In that time, I learned a lot of information from students that, I am sure, parents would prefer I had not learned. The one that stands out the most to me was the boy who accidentally let it slip to the entire class that dad has a small penis. The bell hadn't rung to start class yet, so I was letting the kids, 7th grade, be a little crazy and get some of their pent-up energy out before we began class. I hear one boy say to another, shut up, you'll always have a tiny dong. The kid, in a moment of suicide by words, just said, I've seen my dad naked, he's tiny, you're probably right. Thank God the bell rang and I was able to move the kids onto their actual lessons. Maybe he didn't yet know about the whole grower, not a shower thing yet. A bit different but nonetheless hilarious. My stepbrother was in kindergarten and his teacher overheard him say to about 5 other kids, I've been to heck and back and let me tell you, it's freaking scary. The teacher had to discipline him but then right after stepped out of the room and proceeded to laugh her butt off. Haha, this could be really funny or really sad depending on what he experienced. It was my own child actually. My husband had just quit smoking and my daughter was in kindergarten had proceeded to go and tell everybody that her father had quit doing drugs. Tobacco equals drugs. I had quite a number of co-workers and parents come asking me if everything was okay at home. Technically right. I wasn't a teacher, but I used to have a small farm with the usual farm animals. I also went to schools and brought along animals and educated the class on animal care, etc. I always invited elementary school classes to come take a tour of the farm and entertain the children. Every year the teachers took me up on the offer. At the time I also had several animals up in the house, including a few squirrel monkeys. One of them was really old and she had no teeth. A young boy in the 2nd grade was laughing and playing with that older monkey while I talked to the class that surrounded the monkey cages. The old monkey was gumming his finger and he couldn't stop laughing. Finally the little boy said, hey Jacob, Come here and let her bite you. It feels just like grandma. And while showing them the possum I was bottle feeding back to health, a little boy said he had a bunch of them in his bedroom closet. Just the usual farm animals, you know, like monkeys and possums. Not me, but my husband has a student whose mom has a massive crush on him. She tells him all the time about how her mom primps before they do anything online, so she can lean in and say hi to him. My best friend is dating a male teacher. Anyway, he told me that when he was in school he was explicitly warned against dating any of the moms. Apparently single moms might see male teachers as dependable with a good job and then attempt to date them. And this is a common enough occurrence that the professor warned him about it. I don't think this is a secret, but as I was waiting for the class to start, I sat at the back and this girl turned to me and started telling me about how her mom fell on her butt while she was in the shower and hadn't showered for days after the injury because she couldn't do it. Here's a quick one from my wife, the grade 3 teacher. Daddy had to sleep on the couch last night because mommy found out about his girlfriend. When I was a camp counselor, this kid would not stop talking about how his dad beats up his GF. But the kid wasn't saying it as a confession or anything. Like he would get all excited and say it anecdotally. Things have been pretty depressing recently, so here's a funny one. A kid in one of my classes told me that they learned that Santa isn't real, and in fact, it's actually their parents eating the milk and cookies. But, as they said, it's not right they have to make the milk and cookies and eat it. They cook for me and I eat it. So I learned how to make cookies and pour milk now. So wholesome. They told me they have a younger sibling, and they're going to keep making milk and cookies for Santa until their sibling gets older and they'll teach them how to do it too. Wholesome AF. I was discussing homophones with third graders and we were considering the words fair, what they mean and how they're spelled. I was sure we had exhausted all the meanings. Fair weather, playing fair, bus or taxi fare, etc. I thought we had it covered, but no. Have a new one more, you know, fair, when your mom has a fair and your dad finds out and gets really mad about it. I'm not often speechless, but that left me floundering for a moment. Sadly, those parents were divorced before the end of the school year. That's not where I thought this was going, lol. I was walking a new student to IT and they happily shared the story of his fat cousin who is wanted by the sheriff because he's behind in his child support. The fat cousin is fat because he drinks energy drinks and not water, and he doesn't pay child support because he doesn't like kids. Fat cousin also smells a bit like cheese and his feet have long toenails. And so on and so forth until we arrived at the IT office. Go on. When my daughter was in kindergarten, I was at a parent-teacher conference, and the teacher said something about my daughter's little sister dying. Apparently my child wrote a lovely story about her little sister dying and the trashman taking her away. My daughter is my youngest child. I had my tubes tied after she was born. There was never a little sister. There was never a little sister. That's exactly what I'd expect you to say. Boy's mom hit his stepdad in the head with a bat after he had hit her. Knocked him out cold in the kitchen. He was not arrested because he took off to Mexico and now mom is not paying for his papers to come back. Me. That's a beautified dress. Student. Student. Thank you. My mother says it's a beat to wine, smiling innocently. Just spat my drink out, frick, that is hilarious. I once had a student explain to me that all his neighbors were mad at his dad. I asked him why. Kid goes on to tell me his dad had started a fire for insurance money and lit the whole carport on fire. Many cars were lit on fire that night. Kids. In first grade, we had to make daily journal entries. I wrote we went to Orlando for a week. My mom was trying to light her cigarettes and almost drove our car over a cliff. My teacher wrote A++. My mom was not as pleased. On a class field trip to the fire department, I once had a chronic bloater patiently raise her hand as the fireman went around and answered questions. While pointing at the fire pole, she shared with the entire group, including several parent volunteers, that her mommy and daddy have one of those in their bedroom, following up with reassurance that she isn't allowed to play on it. To be fair, quite a lot of people are into pole as a sport, a fitness program, or means to artistically express themselves, often via pole competitions, these days. I have a kindergartner whose dad died about a year ago. She doesn't quite understand where he went, so sometimes when other kids bring up their dad, she talks about him. A couple times she said she misses him and says he's on a trip. Sometimes she says he's coming home tomorrow. I only met her mom once, so I don't know the situation, but I don't blame her for not knowing how to explain death to her 5-year-old. Sorry, I know that's sad, but I work in a low-income area. I have lots of sad stories. That my many students from the same family, same father and last name, had a good reason for looking nothing alike. Dad was in a polyamorous relationship with 3 different women. On interview night he would show up in the family minibus. Glad he showed up, though. 2 girls in the same class, different moms, same dad. He got each woman pregnant within a month. All 3 parents came to parent-teacher conferences together and got along great. Best case scenario for those girls. I know 2 sets of siblings like this. Parents don't get along too great, but the kids seem to be good people. I teach first grade. One of my students once ran back into class after using the restroom and proudly announced, "Nobody go into the boys' bathroom. I pooped and it smells just like my dad's bathroom after he eats Chinese food." That's just good manners. Gives everyone a firm and fair warning. Student 1. Mrs. Kukiracho. Did you meet your husband in a bar? Me. No, we met on a boat during a field trip for my marine biology class. Student 1. Oh, because my mama finds all her boyfriends at the bar. Student 2. Your mama is skanky. Then chaos as the class wants to joke about who has the skankiest mom. I teach preschool. One day my kids were pretending to have a restaurant, and were writing, aka scribbling, each other's orders. One older kid was actually learning to write and would ask me how to spell food items. He came up to me and said, "How do you spell whiskey?" I asked why he wanted to spell that. "That's my dad's favorite drink," he told me. I told his mom cause I thought it was funny, but unfortunately this fact was related to why her and dad weren't together anymore. Oof, that one hurts. My friend used to teach preschool kids. One thing that really hit her was when one of the kids asked her, "Can you be my mom instead?" I was essentially that child but knew the teachers couldn't save me. Still remember that feeling of pining for a mother. Former teacher, our first graders had take-home iPads. One kiddo also had a family iPad with an identical case. They accidentally brought in their family iPad, which had a video of his parents having sex on it. He showed the video to 8-10 other kids before we caught it. Same kid also came to school wearing a bracelet a few months later. It was a dong ring. I admit I don't know much about dong rings, but that sounds like it was a more than reasonable size. During virtual learning, at a time of day where we would just give the kids a little time to talk to each other after lunch, one boy was telling another boy how his dad had hooked up his iPad to the TV so he could watch videos or something like that. These kids are kindergartners. He goes to the other boy, "Has your dad ever done that?" To which the second boy replies, spilling all the tea, "No, my dad definitely can't do that. My dad never comes to pick me up. He never even watches me." Now obviously this was terrible and such a heartbreaking thing to hear, but what was so amusing was just his innocence and candidness as a 5-year-old kid. He just came right out and said it, like, "No, my dad's a piece of crap, man." He just aired it all out. And again, this was virtual learning, so this kid's poor mother is in the background yelling, "Jay, stop it." Don't say that, she was horrified. It was sad to hear, but also so funny to hear him just be so straight up with it in front of a class of 25 kids and 2 teachers. Not a teacher, but the parent. When my, now teenage, daughter was young, I had a roommate who smoked pot before it was legal here. One time they left out their bowl and my child saw it, and decided to draw it for art class the next day. Needless to say, the conversation with the teacher was interesting the next day. I learned one of my students, third grade, was being beaten with a brass strip. It was one of those thin ones you use between rooms whenever one is like carpet and one is hardwood. She beat him anytime he did something she didn't like. He had huge scars and welts across his back. Called DCFS to report it. She had 17 founded cases of child abuse against her when I called. She killed him about 2 years later with a razor. DCFS never did a single thing and we go to jail if we do anything. The joys of working in a city, Chicago. Absolutely heartbreaking. That poor child. In first grade, I would tell all my friends and the teacher how much my daddy loves beer. He drove a truck with beer on it, there was beer stuff all over the house. He loves beer. My dad worked for Budweiser as a driver and would often get stuff through the magazine. I still don't know all that much, but I had a really cool Casey Kane Budweiser hood over my bed. That mom and dad don't share a bed anymore because dad snores. Mom works with my wife and she's not so subtly boinking someone else. Man, flashbacks. That's 100% what my mom told me and my brothers, and I bought it whole cloth. She, too, was not so subtly boinking someone else. I don't think I would call it cute, just mature. I am a bus driver and E started riding my bus in January. She noticed I was knitting a glove on my dashboard and asked who it was for. I told her it was for my daughter, Lucy. She asked if Lucy has any brothers or sisters. I told E that Lucy was going to have a little brother, but he didn't make it. E went on to tell me, that happened to my mom too. It was really hard on her. That was maybe the most mature conversation I've had with anyone in 2021. I came to find out later that E is 9 years old. She went on to tell me how mac and cheese is her favorite food. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.